She passes me by and gives me the most beautiful smile. I can't stop thinking about her. I go back to the same place at the same time every day for 2 weeks. Whenever I see her, my heart skips a beat. I'm addicted to her smile. That was the summer of 2000. I had just celebrated my 17th birthday. I finally get the courage to approach her. Hi, this is my number. Would you please call me? She takes it. No words, just that smile. There was no cell phone at that time. I had to camp next to our home phone and anxiously wait for a call. After a dreadfully long week, she called me. Months later, we had our first date. I was the happiest boy on the planet, proudly told everyone that I had found the love of my life. Every day, I woke up thinking about her. I went to sleep dreaming about her. One day, that sweet dream turned into a nightmare with the words, "We need to talk." "We need to talk." I never liked that sentence. Mr. Contest Chair, Toastmasters, and guests, have you ever thought, have you ever felt the happiest in the morning and the saddest in the evening? Have you ever thought that the show could not go on? She told me that her parents, her family was moving to another country. As a 15-year-old, she didn't have the power to stop them. She said, no matter what, we will always love each other, and one day, we will be together again. She gave me these 2 stones. And asked me to keep them until we were reunited. She said, the pretty one was her, and the fat one was me. Whenever I miss her, I should rub them together like this. That was 16 years ago. I still vividly remember it all. It was the last time that I saw her. In a single moment, happiness turned to despair. I was on the mountain peak, then suddenly found myself at the bottom of the valley. I was diagnosed with severe depression. I wasn't ready for what life had thrown at me. And I don't feel ashamed to say, I even thought that the show could not go on anymore. One day, my mom came to me in tears. I'd never seen my mom cry before. She took my hand and we were silent for a long time. The silence was finally broken when she said, "How do you feel, big boy?" I turned my face away. She said, "You know, Ali, I was 14 years old when my father told me that I had to marry your dad. I was a child, still playing with my friends. What did I know about love and marriage?" Within a month, I was living with your father. In the 1960s, the biggest thing expected from a lady, married lady, was having a baby. But I couldn't have one. I had visited all the doctors in the city, but no one could help. Your father's family blamed me for being infertile. Even your father threatened to divorce me. My biggest wish was to have a baby. I got pregnant after 15 years of torture. I gave birth to a son. He was the love, pride, and joy of my life. 3 years later, your brother was diagnosed with cancer. Those short, blissful years soon turned to deep sorrow when he passed away. The doctor recommended having another baby to help put that tragedy behind us. A year later, I was pregnant again, this time with twin boys. We were ecstatic. That happiness was short-lived too. Your twin brothers died of a blood disease within a year. Your father and I refused to lose faith. We learned a difficult lesson. We must be strong enough for the life's hardships. After those horrible years, we had four lovely kids. You and your siblings gave us hope for the future. My mom's story moved me. I felt ashamed of myself for handling that way my childish romance. That day, my mom made me promise that I would be ready for any kind of hardship or drama in my life. She asked me to stand tall in tragedies and stay humble in victories. Life is full of hills and hurdles. We must forge a way and let the show go on. If we had no winter, the spring would not be so pleasant. If we never tasted adversity, prosperity would not be so welcome. Sometimes life may hit you in the head with a brick. Don't lose faith. Remember, always, the show must go on. I kept these stones as my most precious belongings. They remind me of the day that my mom opened my eyes to the real world. The day that I received the most important lesson of my life. I still rub them together almost every day and reflect on those days. I've had many heartbreaking moments in the last 16 years, yet I know the show must go on.